Hi everyone, I'm Gavin Stone. I'm a product lead at NinjaOne in RMM, and today I'm going to talk to you about dynamic script forms. So our dynamic script forms are a feature that allow you to build custom forms in front of scripts so you can capture different types of information that can be used within the script itself to make scripts that are significantly more powerful and easier to consume from within Ninja. The easiest way for me to demonstrate this is with an example. So let's take creating a local user on a Windows machine in PowerShell. Now, I already have a script written for this, so I can demonstrate the capabilities of that feature for you. If I come into this script here, you can see there's a new feature here over to the right-hand side called Script Variables. And if I click Add here, you can see there's a number of different types that you can choose from. How these show when you run the script will become obvious when we do that later. So I'm just going to choose string or text. We can name this and add a description, which will come in handy later. You can also set these as mandatory, which I'll demonstrate to you when we run the script. And you can set a default value, which will present itself when you run the script. You can see on the left-hand side here, if I just scroll down to the bottom, the way that we utilize these variables is with an environment variable, and that's how they're referenced in the script itself. But don't worry, you don't need to remember what the syntax is for this. You can use our control space feature in the script editor to get our handy list here, and it will automatically just populate what you need in whatever type of script you're in. And this does actually is supported with Windows, Mac, Linux for PowerShell scripts, Shell, Batch, VBS, whatever your scripting language is of choice. If it's in Ninja, we support it for this feature. Let's show you what this is like when it's actually run and shows you how it's displayed. So if we come into Run Automation script here and we find the script that I've got, you can see that a form has been generated that is asking for input. Remember that mandatory field I was telling you about? This adds a star on, and if you try and run this without filling in those mandatory fields, the form will make you fill them in. The descriptions are also great. If you want to instruct people who are running the scripts with a specific piece of helpful information, that is included in the hover over now in the I for each of those variables. So let's fill this in with some test information. Let's just do Gavin Stone 2. We'll do Gavin Stone as the name, just some random things as the password. For the date and time picker, which I think is really cool, I'm going to pick the 23rd of June, and I'm going to set a time of 3 a.m. And we'll say I want to disable this after 30 days, and let's make this a local admin. So I'm going to run that automation now, and you'll see shortly here on the right hand side in the activity stream that we'll get some actions to show the script has run and been completed. We have all the variables that you've included in this particular activity to show you the values that were entered into the script and then used within those environment variables. And if I actually come across to the VM now, you'll see if I just refresh this screen, the user's been created. This is the right one with descriptions and things based on what I had in the script. And you can also see if I refresh the scheduled task that we have a scheduled task set up for tomorrow at 3 a.m. and then one in 30 days time to disable the user, and that's based on that date control and logic that's within the script. So hopefully you will all find this helpful. We're going to be updating all of our script template libraries to use this feature to make it easier for them to run. And I look forward to seeing some of the exciting things that you all build with this. Thank you very much for your time.